Welcome back to my channel. Today, I would like to talk about art prints again. I think it's a very important topic, although I had made other episodes on how to make your art print, where to sell your art print, but I think it's never too long to talk about it again. I think you should totally spend some more time rethinking the strategy all over and make sure that you do it perfectly, choosing all the right things for you, because it can be your main source of revenue if you play it right. So for art dealers, artists, stay with me in this video. I'll show you this new method, relatively new. It's called the YellowKorner method of showing your art prints. So today, originally, I was gonna meet my good friend, artist Li Wei, and go to 7&8 to see an art show. And it's like a performance piece for like half hour, 1 hour. But Li Wei was 2 hours late and we missed the whole thing. And the fact that he went to an art printer to print his works for the upcoming exhibition in Germany, but the printer had some issues and he was busy dealing with the issues and he was not happy with the quality because he had very high standards and the printer wasn't up to the standards. So we were just taking walks in the 7&8 talking about the quality of art prints, the presentation, and suddenly I thought, why don't I bring him to the YellowKorner? So here we go, we went to the YellowKorner. I knew that this is a new store in 7&8, just opened 2 years ago, and it's relatively unknown. But in Germany, in France, in Spain, it is quite well known, and it's one of the reference when it comes to buying art prints in Europe. YellowKorner was originally founded, if I'm not wrong, in 2006 by two HEC or HEC business school students. And those two students are very, very into photography, into business, so they want to make a business of photography. So they have signed over 200 artists from all over the world. In China, they have signed with two photographers. But slowly, they're not only signing with photographers, they're also signing with other kind of artists, like digital artists, performance artists, because Li Wei told me, actually, YellowKorner used to contact me and want to sign with me. And I was like, well, what did you say? And he was like, well, for whatever reason, I didn't sign because my personal reason, I had some like issues with my production. I want to focus on my art. I didn't talk with them, but now I'm reconsidering after seeing how professional, how beautiful the presentation is. And I'm happy that we had gone there to see and I had talked with the staff. And she's very professional and she told me a lot about this business. And the more I know, the more I'm impressed. And I want to share with you, especially if you're an artist looking for a way to showcase your art prints and to make it, let's say, better than just Epson or Canon print on a piece of photo paper, then here is the one of the options that you could go. So YellowKorner prints several sizes and several kind of framing methods. You have the normal paper with passepartout, with signature, and this signature is not made by artists, it's made by the framer. It's like a quality control, a personal touch of this work. And on the back you have the certificate because it's a licensed work and it's limited 5,000 copies all over the world. And the larger works you can see that is printed with metacrylado, diasec, or alu de bon, or sandwich, however you call it, depending on the region, depending on the technology that they are using. It can be called different things, but it's like this, as you can see. And perhaps you have been to art galleries and art museums, and a lot of the works are chosen to showcase like this. Well, this technology was originally invented in the 70s in America, called diasec, patented, and then later they didn't renew the patent, so this technology is widely spread and you can produce it, you know, pretty much just using the technology that they used. But it's not that easy. It is very hard to replicate a high quality because it needs a dust-free room, it needs a high quality printing paper, a very good back, a very good front. That is plexiglass, and the glue is the magic formula. You really need to have the very good special way to glue it so that it's solid and it doesn't have bubbles, it doesn't have dusts. And YellowKorner invented their own way to glue using a 200 degree heating method. And DSEC also used, the original DSEC also used this heating method, temperature change, to make like a super strong and durable glue that is museum quality. And I think it's a very interesting point that although this technology is freely accessible, if you want to do it, you can. But not everybody could do it. Like, if you want to make a nuclear reactor in your basement, you can, but you're not going to do it. It does not only require a lot of know-how, precision work, but also a large equipment, dust-free rooms, the facility, all over, the whole package is very difficult. So what YellowKorner does is they have their production line in France, and they ship their works from France to all over the world. And I think it's a very good point for their quality control, because once that you have it produced everywhere, it's really hard to know how many copies has been produced. And the whole printing quality could be very out of control easily if it's not near. So their ways of centralization is very good. And I'm so surprised by the staff. She knew a lot, and she's very friendly, she's very well trained. And she told me that they trained their staff in France before putting them, you know, to the stores in Beijing. Again, I'm so impressed. Like, I went to other exhibitions and the staff there didn't know even the place. They're like, I'm not sure where I am. It's like, I think YellowKorner has a few key competences that other people don't have. I would call them the three core competence or key competence of YellowKorner, which we could all learn from. Number one is their people. They train their staff very well, they ship them to France to learn, and then put them back to where they will work. And this whole thing really shows they care about their management and they care about their staff. The second thing is their machines, their facilities, the fact that they could produce everything with their amazing quality control and then ship it from France to other stores, so you have the uniform quality that wherever you go, no matter which YellowKorner you visit, you get the same quality, exactly the same, which is very important in terms of art print, because it's not an original art. So if it's flawed, there's no excuse, because it should be the exact same quality for all the prints that you make. And they could make it by centralizing their whole production, which is a very good choice in my opinion. The third key competence is that they have the IPR, they have the copyright license from their artists, or right now they are mainly photographers. It's super nice to have this way to produce art prints, to have the sandwich, metacrylado, alu de bon, DSEC, to have the passepartout with certificate sticked on the back to, you know, sell it cheap and sell it fast. If you are an artist, I think it's a really good idea for you to think about YellowKorner way. Like, you can see what sizes they produce, what prices they sell, what artists they work with, what kind of framing method they use for what kind of works, and what, you know, the whole promotional process. You can like try to make your own YellowKorner, but without working with the YellowKorner, because they pick their artists, and if your art is not exactly suitable showcasing in their galleries, and they wouldn't work with you. But it doesn't matter. You can make your own YellowKorner just by using their concepts. If you are an artist yourself, you have really an advantage, because people like to buy arts and prints from artists directly. They want to feel the proximity, they want to feel the intimacy with the artists, and YellowKorner cannot provide. So go ahead and do it if you wish. If you are an art store owner, gallerist, or perhaps a company who'd like to produce such things with your own content to decorate your own homes, offices, you can also see how they do it and try to see the quality as a reference, because I think their quality is really nicely controlled. And if you can just go to the next YellowKorner and learn, you could learn a lot from them. So that's all what I want to talk about, the YellowKorner way of making art prints. Hopefully it can bring you some inspirations. If you have any questions, leave me a comment below. And I have a lot to talk about in the next video, but I have to run. So see you in the next video.